Hey, Nikki, man, how about all that freezing cold weather we had last week? I mean, I thought froze my earballs off.
Yeah, but hey, we almost got to miss school a couple times.
Yep, just a little more snow or ice at the right time, it would've been awesome.
But you know, it's kinda weird how it mentioned salt in the gospel today. It's almost like the Bible predicted the weather we had across the country lately, and how we had to throw salt on the earth in our driveways.
Wow, Stinky, that is kinda weird. I mean, the gospel reading for this week could've talked about pepper or something, but it didn't.
Hey, guys, what's going on?
Hey, Max. Well, me and Stinky here were just talking about how the Bible predicted all the icy, snowy, cold weather we just had, and all the scary storms across the country. How amazing is that?
What? Yeah, Max. I mean, the gospel was talking about salt. And everybody everywhere needed lots of it last week because of the snow and ice storms going on everywhere. Ain't that kind of spooky?
I really don't think what?
You don't think it's spooky, Max? I mean, think about it. Gospel didn't say nothing about pepper,
or mustard, or ketchup,
or any of the other continents.
Guys, I think you mean to say, common daily mess. Salt and pepper are spices, but mustard and ketchup, those are condiments, not continents.
Really? So, what's a continent then?
I think soy sauce is a continent.
Oh, I am not surprised that you're still confused about the differences between continents and condiments. And I think maybe you're mistaken about the gospel predicting all the winter storms we're having everywhere.
But man, the gospel did predict the ice storm. See, talks about salt. Hey, jeepers, Stinky, do you think maybe there's Super Bowl predictions in the Bible somewhere?
Maybe. Chef Bob, you don't need any help from the gospel. Mr. Hunt tells me you picked the last 5 Super Bowl winners in a row.
Wow, Stinky. That is amazing.
It sure is, but I didn't think Mr. Hunt would count all the way to 5. Anyway, that is a very interesting conversation, but I don't think the Bible makes predictions like that.
Oh, yeah, Max? Because that stuff about salt sure looks like an accurate ice storm prediction to me. How do you explain that, huh?
For one thing, the snow and ice storms have been happening for weeks, and it's this week's gospel that talks about salt. The snow and ice around here is mostly all gone now.
Huh. I didn't think of that. So, what is all the stuff about salt about then?
The salt you heard about was Jesus is teaching us that as his people, we have an important purpose in the world.
Really? How come I didn't get my important purpose yet? Is it because I don't have a place to keep it? My bathtub is kind of small.
Yeah, mine too. But hey, I know. Maybe we can get us a couple of baby porpoises. Or aren't those little porpoises enough?
No, no! Not an important purpose, it's purpose. Jesus was telling his followers that they have an important purpose. He said that we are like salt. You guys know how important salt is, right?
I say, did you ever have some of those potato chips with less salt?
Yeah, they taste terrible. I have no use for low salt or salt-free anything. It tastes like nothing.
You know, I think maybe you guys are starting to get it. But remember, when Jesus talked about salt, he wasn't talking about real salt that we use on food. He was talking about God's people, people like you and me. He said that we are like salt for the earth, and if we get unsalty, that is, if we stop trusting God's promise to love us and care for us, then we lose our purpose.
Oh, I see. Salt for the earth. Did you get that, Stinky?
Yep, I sure did. Thanks for explaining it to us, Max.
You're welcome, guys. Well, I better go now. I'm supposed to meet some of my friends and help them with their homework. It's one of those salty things I do, because I'm one of God's people. Right?
Well, I never was one to eat dirt, but if Jesus says we should put salt on the earth, I guess we better go try it.
Yeah, I know. Let's make us some mud pies. That way it'll look good enough to eat.
Great idea. And I'm sure that Jesus won't mind if, in addition to the salt, we put some mustard, ketchup, and other condiments on it.
Yep.
Go for it, Bob.